are you in favor then or against a lifting of a lockdown from after April 30th, given that testing's still a concern and we can't say if the virus has peaked?
Well, we are really in proverbially between a rock and a hard place. It's a tough choice. Do you let the economy die or people die? I mean, it's really a terrible choice to make. But I think that areas where infections are down and businesses and industries who can handle opening, such as testing their own employees, transporting their own employees, even testing their customers, for example, or the public that they deal with, and transporting themselves, I think that could be given a serious consideration. The one concern I really have is public transportation, because we cannot allow this virus to freely move around society, and that's probably what will happen if public transportation is allowed. So it's really a tough choice.
Ricky, in what way could it be disastrous, a second lockdown for Luzon?
Well, if it gets out of hand again after the lockdown is lifted, say through public transportation, which if you look at New York, the subway really was the vessel for spreading the virus all over the place. And a second lockdown coming from the damage done to the economy now, I can't even say what the impact of that's going to be.
15 to 20% operational capacity is something that you're proposing, but what is that going to mean for jobs? We're not even past 50% with that kind of a recommendation.
Well, if it goes longer, those jobs may not be there anymore. Because small businesses, that's why the government's going to have to, Congress is going to have to come up with a second package for small businesses and the people. You know? Cannot just be giving people money and food, because businesses are going to go, small businesses especially, which is the biggest employer in Luzon, will start going under.
Yeah, and because the ECQ has basically let go of economic growth to save and heal people from COVID-19 first, the economic planners are now flagging weak to negative growth, a technical recession even. What are you tipping for in Q2, Q3, and Q4?
Well, there's no question we're in a recession, whether it's technical, whatever you call it. I mean, it could lead to a depression with a second lockdown. So, I mean, it's such a sensitive balance here. It's really a choice of the lesser evil. Save the economy or keep the economy running somehow or keep all the people safe, if that can even be done. This is something that nobody's ever been through. But the government, I think, at the end of the day, will have to spend an additional at least 1 trillion pesos just to keep things intact, over and above the what they've done already. I mean, over and above the 2020 budget.